Today marks the 20th anniversary of a very magical publication. Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone debuted on June 26, 1997 in the UK. 20 years has given us 7 main books, several spin-offs, a theme park, a plethora of movies, and of course, video games. Unfortunately, most of these games aren't very good, which is astounding to me. Watching Magical Beasts and Where to Find Them last year made me realize there are other stories to be told aside from Harry's, and they're interesting. Games are the perfect medium to realize J.K. Rowling's vision. Why then hasn't there been any true greats? Understandably, there's a lot to deal with when creating a game based on an intellectual property. There are rights to consider, along with following a home of lore. The most important factor is money. It's simply easier for companies to rush a movie tie-in game through development, which will sell regardless of quality, than it is to invest heavily in something more original. Sad but true, and yet there is still hope. Lord of the Rings has made some great strides recently, and it's only getting better for them, so maybe Harry's time is coming up too. What we have right now for Harry Potter is poor. Games that are based on the 7 movies try to haphazardly follow the plot, but because a game can't be a narrowed, short experience like a movie, these tie-ins are padded out with awful minigames, clunky platforming controls, wonky combat, and a laundry list of other groans. The one thing I will give props to is allowing players to explore the campus of Hogwarts, albeit in a truncated fashion. So there are good ideas, but they're caged in a shell of mediocrity. For example, the games based off of the Deathly Hallows 2-part movies are cover-based shooters in the vein of Gears of War. Actually, in the press, they were kind of teased as Wands of War, sort of a little bit of play on words there. The movie tie-ins for the Game Boy versions of the first 3 movies are RPGs, which I will get more into in a separate video. Then there's the LEGO games, and I've complained about them before on my channel. They're just too samey to me and clunky in terms of a lot of puzzle mechanics, and there was also a Quidditch game, which seemed obvious since sports is a big genre of video games out there. There was also that weird Move game for PlayStation, the Wonder Book that J.K. Rowling had her name on, which was kind of tangentially related to the whole Harry Potter universe. Not what I would call good. So again, there have been some great attempts, but they ended up very poor, probably because they were rushed through development. I am hoping for something soon. Of course, this being the 20th anniversary would be the perfect time to do it now, but as E3 is already over, we're probably not going to get any new announcements anytime soon. Before I close out, I want to give a shout out to my aunt, who bought me the very first book of Harry Potter and introduced me to the wonderment. Thanks again, and happy 20th to J.K. Rowling and, of course, Harry Potter. Stay tuned throughout the coming months and or year for more Harry Potter goodness. And finally, thank you for watching. Did you know that was a Reaction Examiner video? If you liked it, you should subscribe to me to keep up with everything that I'm doing. Also, if you have some other interests, like sex, for example, check out Tomops, which is a comedy sex podcast thing wherein my best friend and I check out the weird and abnormal and the erotic. And of course, you should support me on Patreon because, hey, I want to make the channel better and I want your help to do so. Plus, if you want to check out my writing, check out Game Jerk, where I have archives and new stuff for all projects, okay? You can find all the stuff and more in the description with the links below. Thanks for watching, and I will see you all next time.